prove your ability to have known, then you may not know. But circumstances should prevail upon us that, for example, you are a manager of a school, and let's say the proprietor of the school brings funds from other to put into the operations of the school. And at the end of the day, the same year, you have declared profit, the proprietor has taken the profit out. You understand? But then he brings more money into the system. Then what is the use of declaring profit at the end of the financial year? If profit was declared and he took money and brought back a chunk of additional money into the system, you must be suspicious as a manager or headmaster of such a school. You understand? That's what we are saying. That is, at the end of the year, somebody will declare profit and the person has taken money away, but within 2 or 3 months, he brings what? More than what he took away into the system that is coming to increase branches in the system. Then you must raise alarm. So as he said, as AML specialist or money laundering specialist, there are forms that financial institutions you have to fill or report on suspicious transactions, especially those of you in the banking and the financial sector.
In addition to that, we have things we call red flags, which we will discuss all here. Indicators that when you see, you can see this guy, it may be involved in this and that. We see it every day in our own lives, our own family. All of a sudden, somebody is arising. You don't know the source. There are people, when you ask, they'll tell you what you do. A lot of hairdressing saloons, they do a lot of things there. You may see them doing saloon, but they are selling boutique and other things. But sometimes, you ask yourself, you look at average revenue from that. If you look at the lifestyle of a person, is he able to meet that? But that doesn't mean he's a launderer. But before you are called upon by FIS or any intelligence agency, they would have gathered intelligence on you for a long time. Like Vicky Hammer, when we talked about $1 million. Now, I've told you this, I will share examples, but they are placed for academic illustrative purposes. FIS wrote to all institutions to provide account details of Vicky Hammer. And it became a big problem. But the question is that if you say on any videotape that your objective is to make $1 million before you leave politics, your salary is known, $7,200, how are you going to make the $1 million? So all things being equal, somebody will start suspecting you. And the indicator of suspicion is determined by whoever is looking at it. So if it's in any other world, or any other country, they would have put more emphasis on that thing. And she'll be invited for a lot of investigation to prove where she's going to get the $1 million. So just a mere utterance can create suspicion. Actions, lifestyle can create suspicion. And in all these things, we find what we call suspicious activities. So it's like I said earlier, money laundering is a very difficult thing to get. But your suspicion, your way of doing things is what would allow investigators to start working on you.
Okay. So as I said, or as I've been saying earlier, money laundering is a derivative case. In fact, the first case of money laundering was with a man known as Lando Matago. We have heard about that case where he was convicted for tax evasion. Meanwhile, the funds or the business